introduce myself. My name is Exelina Sarsatila from class 2020I with ID number 031. Then also introduce my friend.
Hello friend, my name is Yunita Rianti from class 2020I with ID number 002.
Hello friend, we will presentation about understanding the concept of classical economic thought Adam Smith. Take a look.
Adam Smith background. Adam Smith born on 5 June 1723 in Kirkcaldy, Scotland. John Adam Smith was the son of a Scottish barrister as well as a traditional financial supervisor. Adam Smith studied at the University of Oxford from 1740 until finally getting a professorship at the University of Glasgow in philosophy in 1751. In his thinking, Adam Smith was much influenced by some of the great thinkers before. One of them is Francis Hutcheson, who underlies Smith's love for the natural order. Some of the naturalist notions that inspired him include Greek Stoicism, Epicureans, Roman Stoicism, among others Cicero, Seneca, and Epictetus. And the next is Hobbes, Bacon, and Locke. Adam Smith was the first academic to become an economist.
Okay, next creation by Adam Smith, The Theory of Moral Sentiment, 1759, and Inquiry into the Nature and Cause of the World of Nations, 1776, Essay on Philosophical Subject, published after 1795, Lecture on Jurisprudence, published after 1976. Smith laid the foundation of classical free market economic theory in each of his work, The Wealth of Nations, in one of his work that can be used as a reference for the discipline of modern economics.
Classical economic theory. The first Adam Smith classical economic theory, which was put forward around the 18th to 19th centuries, sparked the birth of capitalist economic theory. Adam Smith's economic theory at the time had influenced the world economy even today. The second is Adam Smith's theory is related to the classical economic system. In general, it puts forward the accumulation of capital on large scale and is able to enter the economic system of developed countries such as America and Europe. The third is the core of Adam Smith's economic theory is mercantilism or elimination of individual welfare, or also called laissez-faire. Mercantiles are also trade protests, which were the forerunner to the birth of classical economic theory.
Okay, the term that is string rod is the invisible hand, where there are invisible hand cable of regulating the market mechanism that turn axis in every economic actor by obtaining income and also maximum prosperity.
Two classical economic theory triggered by Adam Smith. The first is theory of economic development and the second is economic growth theory.
Okay, next theory of economic development, natural law. Adam Smith classical economic mentioned that there were natural law in ancient times related to economic problem. The assumption related to this theory is that everyone has the right and is free to fulfill their need for individual gain. Meanwhile, in meeting this need, this theory is supported by the concept of the invisible hand, or what can be called the invisible hand, which will help economic actor achieve maximal property. Adam Smith also said about the market mechanism that will run and regulate itself.
The next is division of work. In the division of labor, Classical economic Adam Smith mentioned this as a prelude to economic growth. As for this theory include an increase in the workforce, which of course will be associated with an increase in the skill of the workforce. This of course will include saving time in the production of goods, as well as the invention of machines that function to perform energy efficiency. Of course, the division of labor will increase along with the wheat market and with the increase in population and also transportation facilities that support the occurrence of an even greater division of labor.
Okay, next, the process of raising capital. In classical economic theory, Adam Smith also explained the addition of capital rather than the division of labor. Adam Smith said, "Future capital is an absolute requirement in building an economy. That's why problem in economic development will certainly occur widely. In addition, the ability of individual and humans to invest more capital." The theory also explained the importance of saving, which can then be used as capital.
Economic growth theory. The theory of economic growth will encourage population development and economic development. These two things will later expand the market, where the market will create specialization in terms of the economy. Specialization in terms of the economy will also eventually increase economic activity. Adam Smith said that in ongoing development, the development process will take place consistently and steadily. In Adam Smith's classical economic theory, the number of workers will eventually also experience a reduction. This is because entrepreneurs are starting to convert technology to be more efficient and standardized.
That is all. Thank you, friend.